Welcome to Ecoholics. We will discuss in this video how to qualify this UGC NET examination. We have this year's UGC NET examination on 8th July 2018. So roughly we have 75 days. I myself qualified UGC NET twice in the year 2016 as well as in the year 2017 and also qualified the state level MP set that was conducted by MPPSC. So in this video I will share some of my experiences, how to cover the syllabus, how to cover the vast resources that we are talking about. My subject was economics, but you can follow this strategy for any other subject. So first of all, we need to discuss the changed pattern, the newly adopted pattern by the UGC NET. So according to a new pattern, there will be only two papers. Paper 1 and paper 2. So first of all, we'll discuss how many questions will be there in paper 1, then marks allotted and the time limit given to you. So in paper 1, that belongs to some general knowledge, like for example, teaching aptitude, communication, reasoning questions, data interpretation, environment, higher education, some governance question will be also there. So these are general questions, comes out as 50 question of 100 marks. It means 2 marks consist of 1 question and the time limit given to you is 1 hour. Talking about paper 2, there will be 100 question of your particular subject, like you have done MA in economics, then paper 2 will consist of only economics question. The marks given is 200 marks. Then the time limit given to you is 2 hours. Now after that, we need to understand how we should focus the balanced time, whatever we have around 70-75 days till present. So how to balance paper 1 and paper 2. Now in this video, we'll discuss general strategy to cover the syllabus. Paper 1, I will cover separately in another video, and paper 2 of economics, because my subject was economics, I'll cover very vastly the paper 2. Now talking about what kind of strategy you have to follow, because this examination consists of multiple choice questions. So first of all, multiple choice questions. So MCQs are comparatively simpler if you have vast horizontal knowledge. It means in order to qualify this UGC NET examination, you need to be well versed with the horizontal amount of knowledge. It means they are not asking in depth, talking about certain circumstances, certain exceptional question, but your knowledge should be based on horizontal basis. It means you need to cover all the parts given in the syllabus. Like suppose, for example, if you download the syllabus from UGCNET website, you will find that there will be a syllabus of around 7 to 8 pages. So my first advice is to convert that PDF into Word file and separately convert it into bullet points of that particular topic. So topic wise, you have to identify, because the vastness of the syllabus will kill you. So like in order to qualify, in order to expand your horizontal knowledge, you have to stick with the syllabus. So second one is your syllabus. It means whatever will be the syllabus given in the UGC website, you have to find a particular topic, and on that particular topic you have to develop some peripheral topics also. Like for example, if we can consider, like in economics we have some general theories like theory of demand. So consumer demand theory, it means we have to cover Hicks and Hansen also. We have to cover Marshall's theory also. We have to cover ordinal approach. Then we have another theories of demand for money. So here we can understand that in simple sense, like we have to cover, this is the core of the topic, then you have to prepare the periphery of that. So because the topic given in the syllabus is indirect sometimes, and the topic covers a vast amount of subtopics. So if you find some topics like that, you have very vast amount of resources, then just copy the whole syllabus on the MS Word file, and then according to your knowledge or whatever given in the past year's question paper, you just subdivide these topics. So if you have around 100 topics from that particular syllabus of a particular subject, then you have divided into some sub points. That is also very important, because subdivision of the topic will also be done by the paper setter. So the third point you need to understand is thinking. Thinking means thinking from examiner's point of view. Suppose you make some question, 5 or 10 question, it means your mind will work as the paper setter's mind. It means whenever you will build the questions, you will get to know that these topics are important. So first you have to think from examiner's point of view that these topics are important. We can expect question from these topics. So apart from this, this thinking level is also very, very important, very, very vital. Apart from this thinking, you have to cover the syllabus. Like, covering the syllabus doesn't mean that you just read the topic from that particular book. Finding the resources is very, very important. So finding the resources, fourth one. It means whenever you will read one topic, it should be from only one source. Suppose you are finding one particular topic in many books, it means no need to cover the same topic from particular books. Or rather, you will prepare that one topic and repeatedly revise that topic from that particular period. So it means one topic from one source. That is the most important, because time is constrained. We have around 70 to 75 days. So that is very, 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 very vital to save time. Now, apart from this, if you are segregating the question papers also, it means last 3 years question paper is very important. If you are identify that particular line in the syllabus, then you have to write the questions, or you have to identify the questions related to that topic. So it means you can go also in the reverse direction. This examination is all about demand. So it means you have to see the demand of the examination. And by seeing the demand of the examination, you can analyze the question paper, then getting back to the syllabus. And then after that syllabus, you have to cover from that particular book. So that's the strategy you should follow, because we have a limited time. Apart from these main things, in MCQ while solving multiple choice questions, you have to follow the elimination method. It means from option, four options given to you, A, B, C, D, you have to eliminate one option. Like generally, if you studied well, it means it is very easy to find out that irrelevant option. Then we have three options, and when because there is no negative marking in this examination, so you can always think about attempting all the questions. It means I must say that you should attempt all the questions. If you have any other query, any other doubt regarding this exam, you can put the question in the comment box. Just hope you like this video. Please like this video, share with your friends. Also hit the subscribe button as well as the bell icon so that you will get the notification of the new video. If you have any doubt, if you want syllabus from my side, if you are unable to find any syllabus in the UGCNET, just mail it on my email ID that is given in the description of this video. Again, thank you so much. Have a nice day.